So yesterday, after minutes and minutes of deliberations, the jury in the Eugene Carroll assault and defamation trial came back with a verdict against Donald Trump, finding him liable for both the assault and, of course, the defamation. The amount of the damages is expected to be about $5 million that Trump will have to pay to Eugene Carroll. And because he's going to lose money and because he lost the case, Donald Trump took to Truth Social and completely flipped the hell out. He sent out an all caps post that said, "I have absolutely no idea who this woman is. This verdict is a disgrace, a continuation of the greatest witch hunt of all time." Whew. All caps. Angry, right? And then I guess what happened is a little bit after that, he was able to calm himself down a bit. So then he puts out a video where he just makes things so much worse for himself. Here is that video that Donald Trump put out last night. Take a look.
A Trump-hating, Clinton-appointed judge who went out of his way to make sure that the result of this trial was as negative as it could possibly be, speaking to and in control of a jury from an anti-Trump area, which is probably the worst place in the United States for me to get a fair trial. We'll be appealing this decision. It's a disgrace. I don't even know who this woman is. I have no idea who she is, where she came from. This is another scam. It's a political witch hunt. And somehow we're going to have to fight this stuff. We cannot let our country go into this abyss. This is disgraceful. You have somebody running for office. You have a woman that's financed and lied about it. She totally lied about it. By Democrat operatives, like just about the biggest one there is. And she said that wasn't true. They found that she lied about it, and the judge wasn't even, I guess, letting it be put in as evidence. The whole thing is a scam, and it's a shame, and it's a disgrace to our country.
Now, the reason I say that Donald Trump went and made things so much worse for himself is because, as he points out in the video, he's going to appeal this ruling. But he also actually announced before the verdict even came in that he was going to appeal the ruling no matter what it was. He said, no matter which way it goes, I'm going to appeal it, which actually already ruins most of your chances to be successful upon that appeal. When the appeal is premeditated and not based on any kind of real complaint, that is taken into account by the appellate courts, and it's unlikely that Donald Trump will be successful in getting this verdict overturned. And then, of course, as he pointed out in that little video, well, he didn't point this out. I'm going to point out what he did in the video. He lied. He lied repeatedly. He lied about the judge. He lied about Eugene Carroll. He lied about the facts of the case. He lied about the jury. We actually do know that there was one, like, hardcore right-winger on that jury, and even that person was like, nope, looks like he did it. So you lost your own crowd on that one, bud, mostly because Joe Tacopina was absolutely horrendous during this trial. Like, you really get the impression when you read some of the transcripts, when you see his questions, Tacopina just didn't even want to be there. Like, he was like, listen, I don't want to be here. You don't like me. I don't like you. Can we just wrap this up? I want to get home and watch Survivor. That's pretty much how Tacopina acted throughout the trial. Donald Trump, of course, declined the opportunity to show up and confront his accuser, as he said he was going to do last week. And the rest is history. Yes, Donald Trump can appeal this, but this isn't a court ruling. This is a jury verdict. It is much more difficult for any appellate court to overturn the verdict of a jury. What is more likely to happen is that maybe if Trump is able to make any successful arguments, which based on his legal team, I don't think he can, what would probably happen is maybe they'd reduce the amount. Right? We see that all the time in jury trials, especially civil, you know, cases like this. When it is a situation where the jury gives a ruling and a punishment, the appeals typically only deal with that punishment. So Trump's not going to get the verdict overturned. He may be able to reduce the amount he owes by a little bit, But even that seems a little far-fetched, because in order to do that, you're either going to have to prove that the damages are excessive and unwarranted, which I don't think Trump can prove, or in order to turn over the jury verdict, you're going to have to prove that there was malfeasance among the jury itself. You're not going to be able to do that either. It is what it is, and all I got to say is, I bet that CNN town hall tonight's going to be pretty fun, huh?
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.